Hello everyone, my name is Maxim Kozlov and I will be your guide in studying selected etudes from 113 etudes written by Friedrich Dotzauer. Let's work on the etude number one. We will use all different parts of the bow in this etude. Also, we will have to use extensions in the left hand to reach F sharp on the C string. With the fourth finger and B flat on the A string with the first finger. I will play this etude in tempo quarter note 84 and I will not be using vibrato for you to be able to pay attention to the bow distribution, dynamics and quality of the sound. Thank you. Etude number 2 is an exercise for martelet, that is the bow stroke, which is done in the upper part of the bow. It is very active bow stroke with very clear and well articulated beginning of the note. To be able to play it as clear as possible, it is recommended to turn the wrist slightly towards the index finger. This way, the fingers are in more active position. That is very helpful to make every note to respond quickly and clearly. Thank you. Etude number 3 is an exercise for legato. The challenge here is that we'll have to play different number of eighth notes per bow. Sometimes we'll have to play 12 notes per bow, sometimes 8, and sometimes 4. Considering that those eighth notes stay in the same tempo, and we always need to use the whole bow, we'll have to use 3 different bow speeds. The slower bow speed will happen when we have 12 notes per bow, we play 8 notes per bow with faster bow speed, and the fastest we'll have to play when we have only 4 notes per bow. Pay attention, it's not about the speed of the 8th notes, they are the same. I'm talking about the bow speed. Many times in this etude you will have to move the bow from one string to another during one bow stroke. To make very smooth string crossing, you will need to make sure that your wrist is in a very flexible position. I also suggest to make sure that your elbow starts moving before you make a wrist movement. That is, when you, for example, have to go from G string to D string, you'll start like this. Then your elbow will start moving up, and at the last moment, the wrist will join. The same is true when you move a bow from D string to G string, or A string to D string. So you start, for example, on the D string, and then you lower the elbow first, and then your wrist joins. If you don't do it this way, if you change the position of entire bow arm, you will most likely make an accent, and it will be very hard to hide the string crossing. I'll play middle part of the etude where we all pay all attention to string crossings. You could see that I wasn't moving the elbow together with the wrist all the time. They were quite independent, and usually the elbow moves to position of the next string first, and then the wrist follows. So we'll start making snake-like movement. Very flexible wrist is the key to do it right. In the middle part of this etude, you'll have to make crescendo and diminuendo during the same bow stroke. So you'll have to accelerate the speed of the bow to make a crescendo, and then decelerate, slow down to make a diminuendo. That's a good idea to start those bow strokes with a slower bow speed, so you have some room for acceleration. I'll show this idea while playing the same note on the open string. And now I'll play several measures from this etude.